We have already done these few sentences earlier last time, but a couple of them we'll see again. Actually, the whole section is revealing us the process by which the creation started from below. The process from which the creation started from below. Of course, we had the void, the Supreme withdrew entirely into Himself. He emptied Himself out completely, and when He emptied out completely Himself, He plunged into it. He plunged into it, and He became the support of that void. When He plunges into the void, then Mother conceived the first avatar. When He comes here in that form, He also comes along with His power, this force. Now the whole metaphysics is that He remains quiet, silent, inactive, passive. But then He allows her to do whatever has got to be done. It is her job now to bring out creation after creation or whatever has been. He will support her. He will give necessary basis for her. He will give sanction also to her. Yes, go ahead. But then the entire dynamics of the process is a job to be done by her. So it is in the metaphysical terms again, you have got Satyam, Satchit, Ananda. Now, the two aspects of Satchit, Sat and Chit, are what are coming into play. Sat becomes the inconscient being. He becomes the soul of the creation here. And Chit becomes the dynamic consciousness force working out things here. You see. So, it is the entire play of now Satchit or of the soul and Prakriti, Purusha and Prakriti, in the other words, you see. So the whole play goes on. So the entire emphasis is now from that point on, whatever has got to be done, it is she who is going to do it. It is her work to bring out creation. He has now remained there quiet. He is asleep on a serpent with 1,000 hoods. That is the Puranic image. He is asleep on a serpent on a... Now, the serpent means the energy. 1,000 hoods means the 1,000 qualities of Ananta, which will come into manifestation. He is asleep on that. Now, to bring out those 1,000 qualities is her job, his, her work, her concern, her strategy, her effort, struggle, whatever you want to call it. It is her job now, you see. Now, therefore, a secret spirit. Now, again, secret spirit corresponds to the Satchitananda. Satchitananda without Ananda part of it. Without the Ananda part. Ananda is always there behind the whole thing. But it is the part of Sat and Chit. That is the spirit which comes here into the dynamic. Her, the secret spirit. Whose secret spirit? Of that transcendent one. The Supreme Himself. Of the Supreme Himself. That is the secret spirit. Satchit, you see. And he is now in the form of his sleep, and his energy, the consciousness force, it is she who is active. So you have got now the inconscient sleep, the spirit in the inconscient sleep, or the inconscient Vishnu, or the inconscient avatar, or the inconscient being. That is the one aspect of it. The other aspect is of the consciousness force, which is now in the beginning without any shape, without anything. Voiceless word means things had not come into expression. Voiceless word. All the expressions are kind of held back in that poise, in that condition. Expression means the creative possibility is coming into manifestation. All of them are held back, so to say. That is why voiceless word. He was here. He. That one. He was here before the elements could emerge, before the elements could emerge. Now, it is this particular aspect we are trying to see a little more in detail. Elements could emerge. Now, so basically, we have got the inconscient self, and you have got the active dynamic shapeless energy to begin with. Now, before the elements could come out into existence because of her, he is lying there asleep, you see. He is lying there asleep. Now, the question, he was here before the element. He means the transcendent one, was already there. And now the elements will come. In other words, bringing out the element is her problem, is her concern, is her pursuit, is her effort, is her labor received. Now, the question is, what are these elements? Emerge. Who is going to bring them out? Who is going to make them emerge from that condition? She. It is she alone who can bring them out, those elements. Now, what are these elements? We have seen last time in a kind of a hurry, and even today it will be kind of a hurry also. We have seen that in these elements we can see at three levels. Element in the form of a chemical elements. We have got now 92 established elements, they have gone up to 108. Pursuit is whether you can create an element which is 127th, atomic number 127. It is said that atomic number 127, if you are able to produce that thing, it remains stable. It does not disintegrate. It is not radioactive, 127. So after uranium, you have to jump all the way to 127 and then it remains element. Now, whether he is talking of these elements, these chemical elements in this process. Well, if these are the elements, the basis of matter on which the entire material creation is established, so there is a kind of a justification in attributing these chemical elements before he was born, you see, before he came out, you see. Now, the question is, before the elements could emerge, did these elements emerge at once, or they emerge gradually? Yes, you have said elements could emerge. We can understand that. But did they come out suddenly, all of them together at once? Or they came out as a process, as a sequence, one after the other? The scientific theory speaks of the Big Bang event. And after the Big Bang, you had only the plasma of electrons and protons completely. Now, in the course of the evolutionary process of the universe, scientific universe, these elements came one after the other. All the elements did not come out simultaneously. First came hydrogen is there, then came helium, then came other higher and higher elements like that. So, there is a kind of a chemical evolution after the Big Bang. I mean, these elements did not emerge at once. There is a process of evolution by which these elements came. And when the evolutions had come to a sufficiently good number, then at a certain place, there was a possibility of life coming, of other types of things happening there, you see. So, when the elements could emerge, is not here, scientifically speaking, a single one-time event. It is an evolution of chemicals themselves, of the elementary particles themselves, by which the chemistry of the universe or the cosmos is built. For instance, even in the sun doesn't have other elements at all, except for a few. It is only a plasma of oxygen, of nitrotons and electrons, completely, see, plus a few elements like that. So, the evolution comes later on as a process of sequence, see. So, the elements did not emerge at once. That one thing is certain as far as scientific theory is concerned. Now, these elements could also refer, as I said last time, to the Sankhya elements. Pancha Mahabhutas, five great elements. Pancha, five. Mahabhuta, great elements, characteristics. That is, Prithvi, Aap, Tej, Vayu, Akash. These are the five elements, Prithvi, Ahav, Tej, Vayu, Akash. Now, did all these five come at once? Again, that question arises here also. Did in the process, did the Sankhya tell us anything that these Pancha Mahabhutas, these five elements came at once or they came one after the other? That first came Prithvi, then came Aap, then came Tejas, then came Vayu, then came Akash. Sankhya philosophy is silent about it. It has no answer whether they have come simultaneously, together, at once, or they kind of gradually developed one after the other, came into existence. If they have come one after the other, then you have to give a process. By what process one has gone from one place to the other place? That thing is totally unknown to us at all, you see. Same way, even the very first element, how did it come at all? Prithvi, how did it come at all? Of that we have no knowledge, you see. Sankhya postulates these five elements and postulates their presence, and from their presence then it builds up the material theory. But the origin of these elements and their coming into existence, at what time, where, the Sankhya is totally silent about it, has no answer to that thing at all, you see. So that is as far as the Sankhya is concerned. Chemistry we have seen already. The third thing is, does he mean by these elements, the chemical elements, does he mean by these elements, the Sankhya elements, or does he mean something else? These elements could be material existence, could be the vital life, could be the mental itself, could be the possibilities of this thing here. In fact, it is that aspect which is kind of clarified in the next line. Before there was light of mind or life could breathe, these elements therefore are identified with mind and life. Naturally, therefore, there is matter, there is life, there is mind, and he was present even before they came into existence. He was present there, and later on in the process came matter, came life, came mind. How did they come? They have come into existence because of the working of this energy, of this consciousness force. So here we can easily say that these elements actually are the evolutionary stages of consciousness. Each is a distinct state. Matter, life, mind, many other things will come in the course of time. Later on, all the possibilities of the spirit will exist, coming to be supermind, whatever you want to call it, is later on, you see. So these are the elements which are present there. Even before these elements could come out, he was already present. In fact, because he is present there, that, and because of her work, that these elements could come out. These elements could emerge. He says emerge out of the thing, you see. So I will say that the process of the appearance of these elements is not one-time act, that all the elements have come at once together. No. The process is evolution. The process is evolution. So the chemistry is silent about the evolution. Sankhya is silent about the evolution. But here, these elements give us clearly the idea that it is through the process of evolution that this element after element will come into existence. They will come into existence one after the other, you see.
How did you see?
How did I see?
Yeah,
because this line, before there was light, we know that in the beginning there was no matter, there was no mind, there was no life.
He spoke about element. He didn't say element
Because before there was light of mind, before there was life, he was present.
Scientists
cannot say how it has come. Yes, science, the Big Bang theory postulates the chemical evolution of elements. Now, the Sankhya does not speak anything at all about that.
My question is, now, with Shrobindo
Shrivanthu's philosophy, Shrivanthu's metaphysics here is that these elements are coming one after the other because of her work.
Yeah, how did you understand?
Before there was light, he has indicated that mind has come afterwards, that life has come afterwards because he was present. He was present before life and mind came. Now, in the strictest logical sense, it should have been before life could breathe or there was the light of mind. logically, as we know his theory of evolution, before life could breathe, or there was light of mind. That would have been logically what we would have understood. But poetry allows that little kind of a variation, you see. Freedom for us to understand that, you see. He has not given a complete thesis of evolution here. These elements have come. What are these elements? Okay, let me suggest you life and mind. He is not elaborating anything more than that.
Very clear. He was before the element. In the matter, the physical. He was before the mind.
Yes.
He was before the vital. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. But he was before all that.
Yeah.
And it's absolutely logical. But now, how do we know which one from it was the three elements?
Now at this point, he was there before. We see these physical, vital, mental elements. Now these elements are the work of being brought out by her.
Yeah.
That is the whole idea.
Okay.
That is the whole idea.
But I mean, you didn't give more explanation than the scientists.
Yes. Of course. Yeah, here is a complete explanation available. Science is telling to some extent there is a chemical evolution. Science is telling, Sankhya is not able to tell us whether all the five elements have come together simultaneously or one after the other. Sankhya is silent about that. But here we have got now the sequential emergence of these elements one after the other. And he has simply indicated, okay, mind and life. But then there could be many other possibilities. We don't know what the future is there. Now this is possible. These elements are emerging. These elements have emerged because of our work. These elements are emerging because he is present there. He is holding as if in him all those elements. And it is she who is bringing one after the other, all those things from him, you see. The substance, existence is there. Existence means substance. All the elements are present in the substance. And to bring out those elements from the substance is her creative dynamics, is her work of consciousness force. So I will say that this is a very important statement, metaphysically speaking, you see. Metaphysically speaking, and we can easily dismiss from the description that these elements do not pertain into the chemical theory of evolution as given by the scientist. It does not pertain to the theory of evolution as given by the Sankhya philosophers. It is a process of evolution starting from the beginning. Actually, What do we have? We have got a void. Then we have got the inconscient being there. Now out of that inconscient being, what is it that has first emerged? Because of her, what is that first emerged? The inconscience has grown, has wakened up to ignorance. Because of what? He is asleep, he is nothing. Out of that inconscience, the first thing which has come out is ignorance. Out of those ignorance, the facets are physical, the vital, the mental. At the moment, you see. Then, out of that ignorance will come knowledge. The being, the elements of knowledge will start coming up one after the other. So, the evolution, you can say quickly, inconscience, ignorance, knowledge.